Hey everyone, it's the E-Mendo7 here, and sorry about the wrong sign, I got into a little bit of trouble here. Let me just make sure the lawmen are gone. Yes, they're gone. Okay, so basically everyone, what I'm going to do today is I'm going to show you all of the store robberies in Red Dead Redemption 2. Let's go. Okay, so basically, in this game, there are house robberies you can do, and like scripted house robberies, scripted horse robberies. First, I thought that was Bill. Oh, they're lawmen. Oh, I thought that was Bill. Anyway, yeah, so the first one is over here at the Rhodes Gun Shop, right here on your map. I am still in chapter 2 when I did this, and so yeah, basically. See, you can see all the starting missions that you get once you start in Chapter 2. Reverend Watson, Uncle, and Javier Escuela. And over here is a man. And over here is another man. And this man is dressed in a sailor suit. And now, I am... I don't want any part of whatever sick perversion you're engaging in. I love Arthur. Even as an evil person. It didn't look it, but my karma is extremely evil right now. Anyway, Arthur. Basically, you as Arthur, you're going to go in there, and you're going to rob him. You'll get money and new gun from this, which is amazing. So before I do this, I should probably save my game first. Eastward bound, enter, there we go. Rob the register first, so you can get the money out of this.
Open the register right now.
A dollar, is that damn important to you? Fine, now open the register.
Maybe a dollar. Honest, kind. Yeah, you lose a little bit of Connor. Sorry, I meant to say honor instead of karma. Yeah, I've been playing a lot of Fallout recently, trying to make some new videos for that. I haven't got to uploading them yet, but yeah, anyway. This is the honor and karma system from these games are sort of similar, you know. And what I'm going to do is I am going to get the most out of this. Yeah, nope. There we go. Sorry, I'm a little bit sick right now. I shouldn't really be making videos, but... Here we get a coin purse. And if you're doing the good... And I did this on my good playthrough so I could get this rifle early in the game. Because you don't get this towards the end of until the end of chapter 2. Does this guy have it on his body? I want to see what this guy has on his body. Yeah, of course. Salted venison. That's seriously it. Oh yeah, by the way. Next time I restart the game, I will make a video on how I got Micah's revolver early in the game. It's a pretty bad looking gun right here. Hold on. I keep pressing maintain, but... Okay, it's probably because I'm in here. Here, let me just get everything. Okay. Yeah, and so you get a new rifle. You get the Lancaster rifle, which you usually don't get until the end of chapter 2. And it's not working. Oh. Sorry about my cough. Yeah, and you can steal. I'm doing an evil playthrough, so yeah, I will steal this. And what I like about this robbery is it's quick to escape if you need to. Yeah, if you need to escape, it's quick. Yeah. I'm just, I can't. Yeah, my camera's perfect right now. like as far as I can get it. Oh, jeez. Arthur Morgan. Ah, crap. Well, I messed up. Usually this one's pretty safe, you know? But I messed up on this. I want to see what my bounty is for this one. $20. Okay, considering I've murdered like 3 people, that's not that bad. More in Raiders. What the heck? Now I'm being shot by Lawman and Lamone Raiders. Lamone Raiders. Okay, so I will cut back for the next robbery in Valentine. Oh, hey. Sorry, I'm back. I forgot to mention something to you. Basically, if you... All of these robberies, the ones that take place in Rhodes, Strawberry, I have not discovered Strawberry yet, or and Saint-Denis, which I have not discovered yet, all of those robberies, even though I just did, you can't escape without a bounty from them. Even if you kill the 2 people downstairs, like in Rhodes, as long as you leave. But that's only for the Rhodes case. Like, if you use a knife to silently kill the guy in Strawberry, which I will show you in a moment, then you will not get a bounty. And if you pistol whip the living crap out of... Okay, I'm finally there. I can pay off my bounty. Okay. Now, and if you pistol whip the gun shopkeep in Saint-Denis and all of his men, and like all the people that he's hosting the thing for, that I'll show you in a moment, you will not get a bounty as long as you either knife them or pistol whip them. Yeah. Okay, I will cut back as soon as I get to Valentine. And then I have something important to tell you. Okay, so basically what I did was I bought a ticket to Valentine. Okay, and this is what I told you earlier. This one, guaranteed, you will get a bounty for. Guaranteed. What I like about all of these is that they're all hidden. You have to like actually go looking for them. Like that one, pretty easy. You come to town and then boom, you see the shopkeep. Like you see, like not the shopkeep, you see the guy in the sailor suit get like people telling him that they're not gonna help him. But for this one, shut up. No one likes you. Okay, so basically there are many ways. Oh my gosh, I need to get my stamina up. Okay, basically what you need to do is you need to, yeah, that last one's Carmen Flay. Okay. Either witness this guy bribe the O'Driscolls inside. There we go. There we go. Now you can rob the hidden operations within the store. Or you could look inside or knock on either of the doors inside or outside. You know, this is just guaranteeing you. Okay, and I had to restart my game because of a bug, but earlier I did try this, and when I did this, it did not work for me. For some reason, I've been doing this since I played the game. Since I stumbled upon this, I've been getting this, you can rob a Schofield from this, Schofield revolver. So yeah, I've been doing this from the start of the game, but anyway, yeah, for some reason it didn't work for me last time, but what you need for this is you need dynamite. This, when you can't get like the full robbery out of this without dynamite. And you will get a single thing of dynamite, which is all you need.
First time?
From the opening mission, who the H is Leviticus Cornwall.
Their identity.
Hold on, let me just, okay, the door's shut. There we go. Okay, it's actually working this time. Oh, shut up. Now, I've lost. Okay, I've adjusted my camera, by the way. And yeah, I've lost quite a bit of karma just by doing all these. Karma, I mean, honor. Oh my gosh. I'm not playing Fallout right now. I mean, I want. Sadly enough, you cannot pistol whip this guy like you can with some of the other people. Like, I'm actively trying right now. I'm pressing B. Here, what I'm gonna do.
Put it on the table. You can see we're in the middle of some business.
There we go.
Looks like a nice look.
I'm just gonna kill everyone here, because if you don't kill the prostitute will try to kill you if you don't kill the prostitute. She'll say something like, oh, you killed them. You won't kill me too. There we go. Boom. Where's that? Crap, dumb move. Yeah, yeah, Arthur. We all know, dumb move. There you go. So what you need is you need to blow up this safe as well. Oof. Oh, I was standing too close to the safe when that happened. Oh, I'm such an idiot. Weapons case. Yeah, luckily I won't be losing my kid's revolver since it's also saved on my horse. So you will get quite a bit of money out of this. But yeah. Take the money. And there's money in the safe as well. Why didn't I grab the money that was over here? Take money clip. Take the money clip. Take the money clip. Okay, now if you escape, you could save yourself a really big bounty. But if I were you, I would kill that one guy and then loot everything from here. From the O'Driscolls. You'll get quite a bit of stuff like wedding rings and things. So they said, you have to like go through all of the guards when you do this one. Like, it's really sad, you know? Oh yeah, if you remember where I got this hat from, it's a unique hat that I got from a rancher I killed. Don't ask. Go, go. I want that man dead! Okay, I'm sorry. I will probably die during this. I want the sheriff's hat, okay? Yeah, hey, I'm not killing you guys yet, at least. I just want the sheriff's freaking hat. Where is the sheriff anyway? Like he said, I want his hat. There he goes. You see? He keeps saying that stuff, but I just can't find him, you know? Like, the sheriff's in like a black hat. It's called the Nevada hat. It's very unique. You can only find it in two locations. That's great. Hey, my horse is just dipping. Wait a minute, is that the sheriff over there? No, that's one of his deputies. Luckily, I'm not getting any more money or brownie. There you go. Yeah, so I have over 200, which means I will be able to pay this off. And no. When I stole you from the O'Driscolls in Chapter 1, that means me and you, we're bonding. Oh, crap. Oh, crap. When I stole you from the O'Driscolls in Chapter 1, that means we were bonded. We bonded together. We bonded over killing O'Driscolls. Means... buds now. Okay. I will come back in Strawberry. I gotta go let my dogs out. I just remembered that gunsmith thing. Scarred me for the remainder of my childhood. Or teenagehood, or whatever you call it. Barthood? Simpsons joke, it's dumb. Okay. Hey, it's me again. Sorry, I forgot to mention that gunsmith in Rhodes at the beginning of the video, him, as well as the gunsmith I'm gonna rob in Sandy later in the video, they are the only gunsmiths that won't shoot you if you try to rob them. All the other ones will. Like the one in Valentine. Actually, that's basically it. The one in Valentine, they will all shoot you. The one in Ansburg, the one in Valentine. And after you're done with the robberies, like the unique robberies in Rhodes and Sanity, they will attack you if you try to rob them again. My horse is stamina on my poor horse. Poor horsey. Okay, I'm giving my horse drugs. Okay. Yeah, so I will get back to you once I'm in Valentine. I mean, not Valentine, Strawberry. Oh gosh, I'm tired. Okay, so now I'm in Strawberry. It's almost nighttime, so I have to get this done quickly. Basically, in order to discover it, you have to go down here. And just so you know, I'm in Strawberry right now. You have to go down here, peek into the basement window, and you will find a moonshine still. Arthur, where is I'm in. There we go. You found a hidden operation inside the shop. You can now rob the shop side business. There you go. And I want to get this done quickly before my mission. Would you call me?
How a fool like you can survive in New York is beyond me.
I'll have you know, I'm a theater producer on Supper
Now. Oh, shut up. No, nobody. I mean, I like theater, don't get me wrong. I have some friends in theater at school, but.
Look, listen, you can't
rob the register. Like I said, this one, if you do it correctly, you will not lose. I don't know. I'm trying not to say karma. Because this isn't Fallout or anything. This is a Rockstar game, you know? Edgier.
Not so fast.
I just made that game there. Okay, so I gained some money back.
That ain't nothing. Just a little batch of white lightning to warm the old bones.
Just a little batch of white lightning to warm the old bones, you know, man. Is that. Oh! Oh! Lancaster?
It's down this way.
Steel air shot rifle. Oh, nice.
Nothing to see, really. Just a little drop on the side.
I'll be the judge of that. Show me where the money is. I ain't gonna ask you twice.
Okay.
Yeah, and you will actually find quite a bit of alcohol. Yeah, let's inspect the stash. This guy will not leave, so that's good. Let's inspect the stash. Ooh. Yeah, I do. And just because I'm a douchebag. There we go. That's fair. Hey, this guy was illegally moonshining. My duty as a citizen to take him down. Luckily, you'll also find quite a bit of provisions in here. You know, canned food, canned food, alcohol. I can't carry any more Kentucky bourbon at the moment, so let me just. Where's my. Right here. Here, I'm just gonna drink some of my Kentucky bourbon and then I'm gonna grab it. Look, sadly enough, there is no moonshine. Earlier today, I have some moonshine on me. Where is it? Right here. But that's because I did a mission in like an outlaw's. Like I did like I robbed some outlaws at Lonnie's shack earlier today. Well, earlier right before I started making this video. And yeah, and that's how I got some moonshine. But sadly enough, you cannot take the moonshine here. Die. Just, you know, kicking this guy's body. I'm beating the dead horse. Yep. I only started playing this like a year ago or so, and there are so much stuff I'm still discovering. Like, the fact that you can't. The fact that you. If you literally shoot the racist in plain daylight, the racist will do. Yeah, people will do nothing if you just shoot the racist in plain daylight. Insanity. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Okay. Luckily, I can just escape pretty quickly. I'm still unknown, which is good. Yep. I hate swimming. Once I'm out of the city, or not city, this is a town, it's a crap shack of a town. Yep, once I'm out of town, then I will go to Saint Denis. Well, screw you, man. I'm just gonna kill this guy really quick, because, you know, this guy makes me really mad. This guy makes me... There we go. And as you can see, I am still unknown and I'm not getting the bounty. Unlike the last two cities I robbed. Not really a city, this one's kind of like a town. Kind of like Valentine and Rhodes. There's really no cities in this game. Okay, and yeah, so basically that's it. Now, I'm going to go back to Rick Station, and I am going to fast travel, considering I haven't unlocked fast travel yet, so I'm going to have to take a train to Saint Denis, and I will show you how to get that one. How to get the unique robbable store in Saint Denis. Now, here's the thing. Unlike all the other ones, where they're, like, outside the store, or you can look inside of a window and stuff. No. In this one, you have to get up close and personal with the store clerk. I'll show you what I mean in a minute. Oh, hey. Sorry, it's me. I forgot to mention that when you, like, explore and stuff, like, here in Saint Denis, back from the mission I'm about to do, like, sometimes when there's poor people on the street, if you help them, which I usually don't, but I usually don't mind playing the bad guy like I am right now, but if you choose to help the poor people of Saint Denis, they might give you, like, information about the store I am about to rob. But, yeah, that probably won't happen for this time, just because I'm just going to go directly to the store so I can show you what happens. But, yeah. Yeah, so that's probably not... Yeah, so that sometimes that will happen, but it probably won't happen right now. Okay, shop is closed. How do you do, sir? Oh, man. I've never been in New Orleans. I haven't really left my home state all that much. I live in the West. I live in the West, so, yeah. But I really have not left the West very much. Wait a minute, am I horsed by you? I'm just gonna quickly run in front of you to see where my horse is. My horse is right here. I'm playing with fire, and I'm in it, okay. Yep. Later, down the line, I might show you where you can get some unique items. I made a video on my old I've had two channels, really cringy content, please don't watch that, but I'm just gonna quickly wait until morning. It's easier if I do it instead of going to, like, a store or anything, it's easier just to wait out in front instead of going to the inn. So basically, I'm probably going to end up doing a series on where I can find unique items. And that will, and the end of that will include my unique guide on how to get Micah's unique revolver early in the game. You can get it in the game, like, normally. Oh, shut up, you. But it's only at the end of the game, like, it's meant to be a reward that you get from... at the end of the game, like, you get all that money by the end of Red Dead Redemption 2's epilogue. You get a bunch of money, probably money from Blackwire as well, like all the money that Dutch and Micah had saved over the course of the game, and probably the money in Blackwire as well. Okay, yeah, so I'm here, so I won't be able to show you how you get that information, but basically what I mean is, in up close and personal, is you have to go back here, knock on the door and someone will say, "This is a private party. Get lost, you mother effer." I'm just gonna turn up my volume really quick on my TV. There we go. See, now I can rob the shop side business.
Hey, get out.
Yeah, this guy, rob register. This guy will not shoot you after you do this. This is the only time that he will actually not shoot you. If you have the option to rob his side business. Oh, shut up. I hate this guy so much. This guy's like a stingy businessman. Okay.
I wanna see what you got behind that door back there. Now!
Nothing. This is a back terrace where people go relax and just get away from everything.
Hey, vengeance is mine, you idiot.
Open up, it's me!
Must be a slow day.
You know how it goes. So there you go.
Where else?
There you go. See, I pissed whip this guy.
Hey! What the hell's going on?
I'm gonna threaten him. I'm not gonna question him. I'm gonna threaten him. Or I guess I have to. I guess I have to question him instead of threatening him. Yeah, sorry about how long this video is. I will.
Guard the back alley? Don't lie to me, you son of a bitch.
Sorry about the language. This game is rated M for mature for a reason.
Alright, you got 3 seconds before your goddamn corpse. 3, 2.
Okay. Take it easy. Little poker game, that's all. Third door, upstairs.
There we go. I was gonna beat this guy up a little bit. Yeah. There we go. And I'm gonna loot you. In case somebody comes over here. There we go. I'm just gonna move this guy's body over here into the corner with the guard guarding the place, and I'm gonna loot him. See, shotgun shells, of course, because this guy's okay. My dude here is running an illegal business. I am a saint. Language, Arthur. Language.
Don't you try crossing over.
There you go.
Oh my God.
Threaten.
Don't do anything stupid. It's all right there on the table.
Yep. And actually, there's a little bit of a secret in here. This is not all the money. The $50 you get from this robbery is not all the money. If you continue to threaten them, one of these guys will tell you that guy over there is holding out on me, or you, or whoever's doing the robbery. See? Which means he will then open it. Language, my good sir. Language. Language is bad for your soul. Language is bad for your soul, my good man. See? Watch. So that was like $40. That was like $50 I got from the table. And let's see how much you get from this. Was about $17. That's not very much. I'm just gonna beat the crap out of these guys. You know what?
You're going down.
Let's torture this guy.
What's your problem?
Okay. So, yeah, so this was all of the money. I got close to around $300. I got like $100 from doing a robbery right before I started making this video.
I'll put you on the floor.
But, yeah. So sorry about how long this video is. There we go. I will see you all in my next video, which is hopefully going to be coming soon. I'm a little sick right now, if you can't tell. So, yeah. But I will see you on my next video. Peace out, everyone.